So like my mom used to go to a Jehovah's Witness church, to this church, to that church, to a Catholic church. It made me seem so confused. And she was like, it's because I want you to choose your own religion as you grow older. Because right now you don't have any knowledge of what they're saying. You don't understand. So whenever you find your religion and you love it, accept it. Because it's your choice. So if you think like Allah, like in a deep thinking, you're gonna like be questioning, like, why does this happen? Why does this happen? And then that's whenever you start doing your research, you know something is missing and you have to go find it. After I converted to Islam, it took me like almost an year, like a month ago or 2 months ago, I told my dad, we were so close. I couldn't hide it anymore. I was like, I'm Muslim. He was just like, no, someone forced you or something, right? And I was like, no. So it's just like, you failed me as a daughter, stuff. And that hits, you know?
Yeah, of course.
And he was also like, I don't want you to have my last name and stuff. But I guess he was just mad.
What if Islam in Spanish didn't exist? Where would this sister have gone?
Okay, so I was on YouTube looking for like Islamic videos, especially like how Hispanic people are trying to convert to Islam. There's a lot of people. And I saw Jaime actually, like, he was getting interviewed by someone, and I was like, Islam in Spanish? What?
The statistics suggest that the Latino segment of the overall Muslim population is the fastest growing.
And then, so I like went to Google and I searched Islam in Spanish in the mosque. It was in Houston, Texas, but I was like, why is there not one in Dallas? So instead of Houston, I put at Dallas.
Bueno, ahora estamos acá en la ciudad de Dallas, Texas, para seguir conociendo más de la comunidad musulmana hispana que sigue creciendo.
So nobody brought you here. You didn't know anybody.
She decided to embrace Islam that day.
Today I feel like I believe in God, and I believe that Muhammad is his prophet. So I feel so relieved. I feel clean. All my sins are away, and I feel great. This is what I wanted to do for a long time.
Imagine if all of these resources didn't exist. Would she still have accepted Islam? Despite the current situation when our centers are closed, we are connecting online with people around the world, and one of them is Julissa, who embraced Islam at age 15 last year after she found out about Islam in Spanish through a Vice documentary online. We've connected online in quarantine and have gotten to know her mother.
Hola, ¿cómo está, señora? ¿Cómo me le va?
Gracias a Dios aquí, mire, estoy muy agradecida de lo que ustedes le están enseñando y que siempre me la apoyen.
If we didn't have Islam in Spanish, it would have been different because, I mean, Allah has everything written, correct? So he knew that y'all were going to be part of what y'all doing right now, and I was going to find my way through Islam in Spanish. And if it didn't happen, then I would probably not be Muslim. I would probably be still living the same old life like before. So it impacted my life. It still does. I would just say thank you, and may Allah like bless you more. Because those people that are like giving to us to learn a new material, then we're giving to other people. And it just keeps going. And then my gift to other people. And that's what's going to spread.
In order to continue on the legacy of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, of sharing Islam worldwide, we're looking for 1,000 pioneering sustainers to support with only $30 a month. As he told us, "Man dalla ala khairin falahu mithlu ajr fa'ilihi." Whoever guides someone to goodness will have a reward similar to the one who does it. May Allah grant you the full reward from everyone we want to serve. Please donate and share this video with your family and friends.